إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، يقول الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us by Surah An-Nisa, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدًا وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُصْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، my dear brother and sister of Islam, I began by saying all praises, all gratitude and all thanks belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek refuge in Allah from the sin that we commit and the faults within ourselves. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide, no one could misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leave astray, no one could guide. We bear witness there is no deity worthy to worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we bear witness indeed Prophet Muhammad alayhi afdal wa azka salam, his final and his last messenger. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless Prophet Muhammad and his family and his companion and whoever follow him until the day of judgment, Allahumma ameen. I share with you three verses from the Holy Quran. The first verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Surah Ali Imran, he say, O you believe, fear Allah as he should be feared and die not unless you are in a state of Islam. The second verse from Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he addressed us a little bit differently by saying, Ya ayyuhan nasu. When he say Ya ayyuhan nasu, he's talking to every mankind regardless what you believe or you are kafir or Muslim, he's talking to everyone. And what he says, O mankind, fear your Lord, the one who created you from one single soul, and from it he created its mate. And from both of them, he created multiple men and women. And fear your Lord and do not cut the relationship of the womb. And surely Allah is watching you. And also from Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, O you believe, fear Allah and speak the truth. And speak the truth and he will correct and forgive your bad deeds. And whoever obey Allah and his messenger will achieve a great success. My dear brother and sister of Islam, today's khutbah, it will be about thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about his bounty and mercy upon us. In next couple weeks, United States will be celebrating a big holiday to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his bounty, for what he has blessed them with. And they call that holiday Thanksgiving. And who are they thanking? They thanking al-wahid al-ahad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They thanking the giver. And who is the giver is Allah. I believe this is how they got that name. Brother and sister, I would like to touch up about thanksgiving and then we can move on in our khutbah inshallah. This way we understand how great this particular holiday is. In the year 1620, a group of pilgrims, they left England, men, women, children, and they decide to get on a big, huge boat and leave England because they disagree with what's happening there at that time. So that boat is called Mayflower. They left on the boat, and sure enough, they faced a lot of difficulties and hurdles, and the weather was tough and rough on them. Some of them, they died from lack of medicine, food, and old age. By the time they got to their destination, they were very exhausted, and they lost quite a bit of people. And mainly they lost the older one, the one they have more experience. And they want to adapt to this new home, and it was not easy. And some of them, they were thinking to go back to England. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so merciful, He understood that they're trying hard and they want to have a better life. So He decided, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to send them a Native American person to assist and help them how to plant, how to fish, how to hunt, and to help them out because they are facing difficulties. And sure enough, that person came in, and then they start seeing the light in the end of the tunnel, and things start getting better, and they start, their hope start building up. They were so grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they were so grateful to that particular person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them. And they decided to thank Him and to thank Allah first of all. And then they start doing that on a regular basis, and it started coming into all about yearly basis. They decide to thank that person and to thank Allah first, of course. Until Abraham Lincoln came in and be the president of the United States, and he decided to make it a major holiday. All government offices stopped. A lot of banks, a lot of places closed, and to worship Allah and to thank Allah. It's a great, great, great holiday that I really like. There could be this is the only or the best holiday I like here in the United States because it's a neutral holiday. It's not associated with any particular religion. And they are focusing on thanking Allah, which is relating to us. Brother and sister, if you search in the Holy Quran and you see how important it is to thank Allah, you're going to be shocked. It's extremely important. It becomes to the level that if you do not thank Allah, become kufr. You are disbelieving if you do not thank Allah for the bounty that He give us. So there is a lot of bounty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He have give us, brother and sister. So as Muslim, we need to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not once a week, not once a month, not once a year, but actually for every breath that we are taking. We need to remember Allah is here and He give us so much bounty. And I'm going to share some of those with you so way you can realize how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love us and He give us so many choices you cannot even count. For example, look at the amount of food, different food that we are eating. You have so many different vegetables. You have so many different fish in the sea. If you try to count only one kind of fish in the sea, you are unable to count. If you try to count how many kind of meat from the birds, rabbits, deers, cows, I can keep on and on. There's so many choices that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us to eat. From the water that you can make multiple kind of different drinks, like strawberry, mango, and so on. Look at the choices that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us. Just, we're talking about just about food. We're not talking about flour for your eyes to enjoy. We're not talking yet about the mountain and all the beauty that we have. And also, I want you to pay attention also the climate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala diversify in every place for you to choose where you want to live. If you want extreme hot, very easy. Go to Palm Springs, go to Arizona, and you can live there. If you want moderate weather, beautiful weather, come to California. If you want to have extreme cold, go to Alaska, go to Europe. Look at how many, just the climate, how many choices that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us. Can you imagine with me, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you one climate only, which is Palm Springs, and all of you would we adapt to the heat? Of course not. How about if He give you one meal only every day, which is rice? You eat rice in the morning, and you eat rice in the afternoon and rice at night, and that's it. How tiring is going to be? But look at how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives you so many choices. And if we try to count it, you can't. بقوله تعالى في سورة النحل بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها إن الله لغفور رحيم. If you try to count it, you cannot, and you cannot even come close to it. Brother and sister of Islam, so we need to understand thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very, very important. I want you to pay attention to the Holy Quran. Find what the first surah in the Holy Quran, what it starts with. The first surah, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. The first surah in the Holy Quran is to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we say in this 17 times a day without sunnah. We repeat that, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, at least 17 times a day. Do we really understand what we are saying, Alhamdulillah? Do we say it with passion? Do we understand the meaning? Do you mean what you are saying? You are really thanking Allah, or you're saying it routinely and you don't quite comprehend what you are saying? In order to get the ultimate reward, brother and sister, and when you say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, you need to mean what you are saying and say it with passion and to understand it in order to get that. And then the end of Surah Al-Fatiha, we have dua. Dua, and it starts with Ihdina Surat Al-Mustaqim. Surat Al-Ladina An'amta Alayhim Ghayri Al-Maghdubi Alayhim Wala Al-Dallin. And then the Imam say Ameen. And we're supposed to, after him, say it loudly with passion, understanding. When you say Ameen, what is the meaning of the word Ameen? Ameen that you are in agreement of what you just heard. When you say Ameen, just like you said that dua yourself, even if you are just listening to the Imam. So in order for you to get the ultimate rewards, we need to understand what we are saying and why we are saying it. So when you hear that any dua, always say Ameen, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. Allahumma Ameen. And also, brother and sister, I would like to bring your attention. Every khatib, when he starts his khutbah, what does he start with? Thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before he says one word. Inna alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiruh. This is every khatib he starts with Inna alhamdulillah. So another word, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been ordered or guided, and for us, we've been guided by him, is to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did that tell you again? That thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is extremely important for us and for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we're going to go deeper, inshallah, and we will understand that's how important it is if you search and understand and read. And also toward the end of each khatib, they end with what they started with. In the beginning, we said, Inna alhamdulillah, when he ends what he said, اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزيدكم. This is the khatib, he ends with this. So the beginning and the end is about the same. So brother and sister of Islam, from the day we were born, we've been blessed with a lot of stuff. Ears to hear with, tongue to speak with, hearts to beat and to feel. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us in Surah An-Nahl, وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا وَجَعْلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. That you may say thank you. He gives us all this bounty, the hearing, and the tongue to speak with. This way you may say thank you. Some of you might say, well, hey, brother, but some people, they are born blind. They didn't get it. There is a reason. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his wisdom for everything. This way you understand, you could be like that. When you see someone like this, and then you say, Alhamdulillah, that I have sight. So this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable to make everyone free from all illness. Everyone is healthy, everyone is rich, he's capable. But he makes it the way he's doing it for a wisdom and a reason. This way you can understand what you have. And especially, brother and sister, when you see a person on a wheelchair, and you are standing up and you can walk, you should say, Alhamdulillah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given me the ability that I can walk. And the person also sitting on the wheelchair, he should be thankful that he's able to sit on the wheelchair. Why is that? Because there's others, they are laying in bed 24/7 and they cannot even take their own shower. So you always, when you see someone less fortunate than you are, is made for a reason. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open your eyes for you to see, to do what? To say, God, thank you. Thank you, Lord, that I can walk, I can eat, I can do the things that I have. And you will never, ever appreciate truly things until you lose it. Try one day, close your eyes for 2 days and you do not see a thing. And you will know what I'm talking about. So we have to be always brother and sister, regardless what we're going through, negative or positive, to say thank you. Because a lot of time, the negative, it becomes, there's a positive behind it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he wants us always to say thank you, regardless what it is. And let me share with you from Surah Saba. اعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور وقليل من عبادي الشكور. من هو الشكور؟ There is a big difference, brother and sister, between الشكور وشاكر. What is the difference between الشكور وشاكر؟ الشكور, the one he thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the positive and the negative regardless. It's ongoing, non-stop. شاكر, the one he say thank you when he have a positive or good things coming toward his way, and he say, God, thank you very much. But when things comes negative, he's not saying anything. So brother and sister, let us be, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us from abdihi ash-shakur, Allahumma ameen. I would like to share with you a little story I heard a few weeks ago. It's kind of a little bit funny, and it might make you understand how important to always say thank you in a positive or a negative. It was a king living in his castle, and he had a helper. And the king noticed that his helper always in positive and negative, he always say, khair alhamdulillah, which is good alhamdulillah. One day, that king, it was screaming so loud, and help, 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 he asking for his helper. And the helper, he thought he's gonna get killed or something's major happening to him. He ran to him to see what is going on. He told him, I cut my finger off. And what do you expect the helper say? Khair alhamdulillah. The king, he got so upset. I just cut my finger off. And you telling me, khair alhamdulillah, he gets so quite upset and angry at him. So he decided, he told his guard, I don't want to see him again. And then a couple of weeks later, he healed, his finger healed. And then he started walking. Usually he used to walk with his helper to protect him and to help him out. So he walked by himself, he wandering away from his castle. He got caught by 5 disbelievers, kuffar, the worship idols. And they said, hey, this is a perfect man. We're going to take him as a karbani to sacrifice him and for their idols. And they took him and they about to slaughter this king. And then soon as one person is going to have the knife and slaughter him as a karbani. And then he screamed, I said, hold it, stop. What's going on? He said, this man is missing a finger. We cannot give our Lord, the statues, a missing karbani, and he's missing a finger. It have to be a complete person. So what they did, they released the king, and he went back to his castle. He went to the helper, and went at his way understood what actually saved him, his missing finger, which was the negative. And then he told the story to him, and he told him, I understand now why you were saying khair alhamdulillah when I cut my finger, because my finger actually saved me not to be slaughtered. But I have a question for you. What is the question? When I put you in jail in here, what was benefit that you got for you to say, khair, alhamdulillah, and I put you in jail? And what is the answer he tell him? He tell him, because if I would not put me in jail and I would have gone with you, I would have been the Qurbani instead of you. I would have been the Qurbani. I would have been the sacrifice. So, and then the king understood, wow. So for every negative brother and sister, there is a positive. Every negative, there is a positive. And let me share with you from Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 26. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَقْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Very clear. And also, I want to bring your attention to really understand exactly about, you always thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the negative and do not be bitter. Do not be bitter. I'm sure most of you have heard the story about the boat in Santa Barbara, when about 36 people got burned, they were going on a fishing trip. You know, they interviewed the people, they missed the boat. And they told them, you almost got on that boat, but you went there late and you missed it. And you were so upset and angry. He said, not anymore. It was a negative for him at that time when he missed the boat. But he found it's a positive that he missed the boat. This is the time when he tell you, do not miss the boat. Now you should miss the boat. And also, even with the airplane, I'm sure you heard it. How many people that been interviewed after an airplane crash, and that person missed the airplane, missed his flight. So brother and sister, I would like to remind you, for every negative, look for the positive. For every negative, look for the positive. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us for Surah Ibrahim, alayhi salam, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِ لَشَدِيدٌ. If you want more money, thank Allah. If you want more health, thank Allah. If you want more food, thank Allah. Whatever you want more, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, thank me, I will give you more. It's extremely, extremely simple, brother and sister. And also, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. Whoever does not thank the people, he does not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How we understand that? Because I want you to understand this. If you hurting for money, you have difficulties. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he put the wisdom on someone else's heart to give you money. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala softened that person's heart and you got enough money. So who is the giver? It's not that person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the giver, but he put it through the hand of that person. So if you do not thank the person, you're not thanking Allah, because they are connected. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one, he sent to us these people to help us. And let me tell you here in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remember me, I'll remember you, and وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Another word, the opposite of shukr is kufr. The opposite of shukr, if you do not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his bounty, you are committing kufr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that directly. And it's not, I have seen it in numerous times in the Holy Quran. It's not only once, at least maybe 5 or 10 times that you will see shukr and kufr right after another. So it is very, very important, brother and sister. And also, shukr, brother and sister, is ibadah. And it's also one of the highest level of iman. Shukr is one of the highest level of iman. Brother and sister, now how we can thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we can put this in action. When you thank a person, sometimes you say, thank you, brother, with your hand like that. Or you thank with your hand, shaking his hand, or the left hand over the hand, over the right hand. Or you could give him a hug to express. Or you send him also an email to express. How are you going to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What you need, the way to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number one, it has to come sincerely from your heart of what about his bounty. You have to be very humble and sincere. And you need to be focused on what you are saying that and mention the things that he have given you when you are thanking him. And also put your thank you in action. Then it's not only with words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you abundance of money and wealth. Share it with others and pay your zakah. This is how you could put your shukr in action. Not just saying, thank you, Lord, and that's it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you health. And here you see someone need to cross the street or someone is unable to push his car out of the way and you are healthy. Help him out. This is you are extending your shukr, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you. It could be money, it could be health, it could be knowledge. If you're knowledgeable about something and you see someone is suffering and is unable to make things work for him and you know how to do it, help him out. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you understand more than him. So there's so many ways, brother and sister, is to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now I want you to reflect on who should be more thankful. We are in this 2019 versus 1500 years ago. Today you are laying in your bed and you can change the climate in your home with the cell phone. Today you can call anyone in the world. Today you can travel from here to other country in an airplane. Versus you used to travel for 6 or 8 months on a camel with the air conditioning. What air conditioning? So who should be more thankful? We are or them? So obviously it goes without saying, we should be more thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of what we have, brother and sister. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إن الله هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وخاتم الأنبياء سيدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله أما بعد Brother and sister of Islam, life is full of challenges. And this is what really makes life so interesting. Welcome to earth. If everything is so easy around us, you're not going to enjoy it. You're not going to enjoy it because it's not challenging. But when you succeed after the challenge, and then you feel the fruit of the things. Just like when you are fasting, the best time to enjoy really food when you break your fast. If you really want to enjoy sugar, eat a lot of salt and see what happens. So you have to have the opposite and the negative in our life. So brother and sister, always strengthen your iman. Strengthen your iman in every possible way you can. And do not be on the edge. Do not lose your faith and be better if anything happened to you negative. Look after for the positive. Look for it after every negative in this world. Wallahi, it have every positive, it have a negative, and every negative have a positive. No question asked about that. So brother and sister, let me share with you from Surah Al-Hajj here before we close. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ فإن أصابه خير أطمأن به وإن أصابته فتنة انقلب على وجهه خسر الدنيا والآخرة ذلك هو الخسران المبين. What does this mean? Some of us, we are worshiping Allah and our faith right on the borderline. Any calamity or any negative comes in, it could push us on the other side immediately because our iman is so weak. So always strengthen your iman. And this is why we come here every Friday.